any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the New England Patriots and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Versus 0-3. Will current form hold? We'll find out as we're off in week four. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Start this drive in the air. Oh, the Buccaneer pressure too much. Down he goes.
We talked about prior to the game, and it played out right there on the first play, didn't it? This offensive line is going to have his hands full all night long.
Now, you often speak of scripts to start a game. Does this mean that play number two, they're going to go off the script a little bit?
Yeah, what's interesting is that most people, when they script now, they actually script those contingencies in, okay, in case they can't run the play they want to. It's long distance now. Let's go to that play.
Got to imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. He's going to loft one deep over the middle. And that's caught inside the 35. And he takes it all the way down to the 28-yard line. A big play there for New England. 55 yards. So that changes things in a big way. Now from all the way down inside the 30, here's first and 10. They'll look to throw here on first down. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. He'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second down.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on first and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Steps away to his left. All in all, no gain on the play, and it'll bring up third.
Well, he strung it out as far as he could, and I like the fact that he kept his eyes downfield, but he finally ran out of time and room. But I'll take that over forcing it downfield and possibly having it intercepted.
Drop to throw. And he's taken to the ground, but he was pulled down by the face mask. Here come the flags. And I believe this is going to be a first down. It's an 8-yard pickup. The penalty moves him into the red zone here on first and 10.
Gone.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And they're going to get him. He's sacked back around the 28. And that is the third sack this offensive line has allowed this first quarter.
Yeah, that puts him on pace. Let me do the rudimentary math here. To be sacked 12 times in a game, I know he's not going to go for that. I wonder if it's going to reshape what they decide to do on offense in terms of play calling.
Well, I can tell you what, when he popped up, shaking his head, frustrated right now behind center.
Gone.
Back to throw. Stepping up, he'll try and run. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. Good yardage there on the scramble, and all of a sudden they're left with a third and two, much more manageable.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
It'll be called a gain of two, and that'll leave him with some options here on fourth and inches.
Over.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he has the first before he's tackled at the five. They opt to go for it, and they get it. First and goal after a pickup of five. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll be stopped about a yard shy of the goal line after a pickup of about three. And the Buccaneers go ahead and take another timeout. And that's their second charge timeout here in this first quarter. They're down to one remaining. Fairly minimal pickup. Call it a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal. Driven it down the field nicely here on the opening drive, and now it's put up. That he's over the line and into the end zone for a Patriots score. A great play there. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Patriots drive right down the field and score on the opening drive. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This will be fielded at the six. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Winston and the Bucs take over now, first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. Working out of the gun, Winston. It's caught by Mike Evans. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 16 yards right off the bat and a first down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And a minimal gain here as he's up to about the 47-yard line. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
And he'll get it down to the 47 here. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
Brad, what were they thinking on defense there? That looked like they were playing for the pass. That was third and short. Yeah, it was an easy pickup because they handed it to him. That was way too easy.
Just looked like absolute confusion defensively. Not sure why they were in that set.
Yeah, I'd say you ought to have a few men in the box there.
Running game working, they'll stick with it on first down. And they see right through that defensively as he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that'll bring up a second and 11. Shotgun, it's Winston, escaping the pressure right, and that'll be incomplete.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
Third down, Winston. Looking for Evans, and it's intercepted. Picked off at about the 31. That's now his second interception in as many weeks from his linebacker position.
And think about all the different techniques he has to employ in a passing situation. Is he spot dropping because it's zone? Is he picking up man-to-man? Is he having to run with a running back or a tight end? In any event, great eyes, head on a swivel, and excellent hands.
Yeah, versatility and showing those hands. He's going to float this over the middle deep. And incomplete, he dropped it in the end zone.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Looks like I-4 at rush hour in your hometown of Orlando, Florida. An absolute mess. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Now back to throw. He's going to loft one deep over the middle. And they went for a big play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. Now it's third. The turnover put him in great field position. They don't want to squander it with third down coming up.
No, not at all. And you know what else you do? You make your defense mad. Yeah. They got you the football, gave you a great opportunity. You got to cash in and get some points.
And now another one thrown incomplete.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
They'll look to throw. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And my goodness, this is incomplete. The Patriots come up empty on fourth down. And the Buccaneers defense holds and they get the football back. So out come the Bucs now. Winston and the Bucs take over now, first and 10 at their own 46. Here's Ronald Jones, first carry for the USC man. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Second down throw for Winston. Flushed out right. Pass incomplete.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of. Otherwise, he was going to get sacked.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down.
Ready. You ready.
From the gun, Winston. The Pats are going to get there. Down he goes.
The competition comes up in so many different ways. And right now, this unit, their competition is who's going to get to the quarterback the most times. Had about 5 sacks last week. We just saw their first one of this game.
They punted 3 times in the loss last week as he sends this one away. Fielded just inside the 20. Sights on the end zone, no doubt, but is brought down after a huge return there. And the Patriots will have great starting position as they take over first and 10. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. They'll come out throwing here on first down. Gonna throw right side here, complete. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. And that one results in 35 yards. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. Fighting for the end zone. He lost the football. It's out. And it's picked up by the Buccaneers.
The psychology of the game never ceases to amaze me, because you would think there would never be a fumble from what we hear from coaches all the time, right?
And how much they practice not fumbling.
Practice it, preach it, talk about it all the time. You would think no one would ever turn it over. Yet they are humans out there running around, and we just saw another one.
Opportunistic by the defense. Winston and the Bucks take over now, first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Ready.
Winston now after the fumble recovery. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
On second down, Winston again. And a hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense, when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion, kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you can go make a play on the football.
The Bucs on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is third and 10.
Hey, stop. Let's go. Sonic. Hey, stop. Let's go. 5 on the 50.
Here's Winston. And a big loss here as he's taken down.
Well, the pass rush has been a real strength of late. They know how to get after the quarterback.
Absolutely. 4 sacks last week. That's their first one here. Anything in particular you've seen from them or on film?
I think that they're winning athletically up front, winning those one-on-one battles. But also, when the offensive line wants to keep everyone in and mass protect, they know how to scheme their way back to the quarterback as well.
Him down for a loss of 9. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long.
Good. Watch it now, Barney.
They're going to look to throw. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And this is caught inside the 5. And he just falls short down at the 1 yard line.
Watch it now, Barney.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that and have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
They'll set up a throw. Being chased out left. And he's going to be swallowed up and taken down. Sacked back at the 5-yard line.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
So they're backed up to the 3-yard line, second and goal. They'll give it to him up the middle. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal.
Well, the spotlight hit him once already tonight.
And he is in. Touchdown, New England. A great effort there with his second touchdown of the game, 4th of the year. And the Patriots add 6 to their lead. And it's 15-0. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not on the team anymore. I just cut him. All right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But so, hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
Winston now to throw on first down. That's caught by the big tight end, O.J. Howard. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion. That's a staple of this offense, drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
And his throw's going to be incomplete.
But one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard.
Ready. Black 25. Hey, stop. Let's go.
Winston on third and two. Open man is got it. It's complete. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. His first catch, good for 16 and a first. He's been the forgotten man in this first half. Not a guy you want to forget. Not only his first catch, first time they've targeted him.
That doesn't make any sense, does it?
Not
because
at all.
Those are the types of plays that he provides. When he does come alive, when they do look his way, not only is it a big catch, it's a first down.
Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll get it down here to the 43. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver. That makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tougher, guys trying to get to the football.
2 minutes remain here in the first half. We'll come back to Tampa after this timeout. The Bucs on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. Here it's third and two. Winston. He's got Evans. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. A familiar ring to that one. Winston to Evans for the Buccaneer first. Got to say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on third and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're going to throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the first down.
A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down. First down, Winston. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. Now we're going to get a timeout here called by the Patriots, as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. So second and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. Now Winston. And boy, that one drops incomplete, but if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things.
Now Winston. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Anthony Brown. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line. We don't see this often. A quarterback of his caliber, 2 first-half interceptions.
It's absolutely surprising because it happens so rarely. You're searching for what reason, what's going on out there. It's not just maybe the defense is playing well. Is his horoscope off? His biorhythms? What is it?
You went horoscope on us, David.
Well, I was thinking maybe REM sleep was off. I'm trying to come up with something.
Anything, right? And that is going to be pulled in one-handed. Wow. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. A big play there. His fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Patriots add on to their lead. And it is now 21-0. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Now the Buccaneer offense set to take over again. And some dangerous territory. You're already down three scores. A three and out here, or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play for a big shot downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one drive. You're not. And last time I looked, it's still the first half. I'm not saying you have ultimate patience here, but you also don't have to go ahead and force everything either.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Now whistles blow, and the Patriots are going to take another timeout, as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely. He's been under constant duress this entire game. I don't know how he's surviving back there.
And to think, there's still a long way to go in this football game. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. On first and 10, Winston. And the pressure gets there, and Winston goes down. The Patriots will take their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle.
Hey, stop. Let's go. Sonic, ready. Blue lady.
5-36.
Let's go.
To throw is Winston. And a catch right side by Evans. Let's go. That one good for 17 as they're set up better now for third down. Final play of the half here, Winston. And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of this first half of play. So at halftime, it's the Patriots with the advantage. So here we go for half number two. The Patriots with the lead, and they will be getting the football. Out come the Buccaneers. They'll have it first to start in the third quarter. They come out here with a zero on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there, because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset that the plays weren't working because of execution? Or did they think they were just bad plays to call?
Yeah.
We'll find out pretty quickly here if they feel like they had something going, but they just need to do it a little bit better or not.
We'll find out.
Green, trouble C. I'm coming after you.
The first down throw for Winston. And oh, Jameis intercepted a third time. Duke Dawson picks it. He had his eyes on the end zone. He got close. At least he set the offense up nicely, but he's probably mad he didn't take that one to pay dirt.
I agree with you, and you know he's going to get teased because he didn't get it all the way into the end zone. But if they don't score now, if they don't get a touchdown, he won't just get teased. They'll be glaring at him. How'd you not score?
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56.
So the false start will back them up five. And that'll set them back five. So from the two, now they move back to the 7 yard line. First and goal. And they'll run it here. And it's been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop him behind the line. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. He already has two sacks to his credit. Now another tackle for a loss.
And you know how you can always identify who was supposed to block him? They're the ones helping up the person who just got knocked to the ground with the ball, right? Whether it's a running play or a pass play, they've got to figure out a way to slow him down. Maybe you chip him with a second guy. Maybe you just out and out double him. Maybe you make sure you take the ball and throw it as far away from him as possible. Because right now, he is wrecking things for them.
They'll look to throw on third and goal. This will be caught at about the six. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the five at the six. A 4 yard pickup, not enough. Fourth down.
Detroit!
They'll set up to throw. And that's going to be caught for a Patriot touchdown. Philip Dorsett, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Pats take advantage of field position on the turnover to cash this one in. Now the try here for the extra point. Extra point right down the middle. And it is 28-0. Is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And the Buccaneers getting ready to go as they take the field. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough, because we always talk about it being a team game and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers. They probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football that makes big plays and give them that opportunity to maybe wake up everyone else.
Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards. Jameis to throw it. Out to the left there and complete to Howard. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
And partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal, because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
On second down, it's Jones. And not much there at all. Maybe a yard up to the 43.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball.
And he goes down. It's a Patriot sack.
It's been a tough one all game long for this offensive line. They're already down big, and now you know they're just going to come after the quarterback in a big way, don't you?
Yeah, they just can't get out of their own way right now. It's created an avalanche, and an avalanche is coming right on top of them. They're indeed going. It's Winston. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off near the 42. And he'll get this one out to the 50 to the midfield stripe.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Forced out to his left. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
My high school coach, John Ford, used to say all the time, if you're in a bad situation, laddie, don't compound it with a bad decision as well. And I think that's what we just saw there. Harassed in the pocket, and he throws into double coverage anyway.
He called you Laddie?
He called me Laddie, and that was the nicest thing he called me.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. They'll look to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
This has been a tough one for this offensive line. It appears almost like they've been on roller skates this entire game, the way they've been pushed around. Six sacks given up in this one.
New England on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This will be third and a mile.
Gone, gone! Gone, gone!
Gone! He'll look to throw. Buying time to his left. Now he'll throw deep left side. And he can't quite pick it. No interception so far. That probably should have been their first. But at least it's fourth down. The Patriots send out their punter. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed till here in the third. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. Now the Buccaneers' offensive unit back out on the field. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. And he'll take this up to about the 7 or 8 yard line. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4. And they'll go on the ground. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. A 3 yard pickup on second and 4. Now they'll need to convert here on third and a little more than a yard.
Let's convert.
And on the ground they go with a running back. And he'll have the first down as he's up to about the 18. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
My 50.
And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. That'll set him back with a loss of 3 on the play. And that'll make this a second and 13.
Green, triple C. 53, check 53. Green, triple C.
They'll try to throw now. Winston. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time.
Third and long for Winston. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. Another drive comes and goes, still nothing on the scoreboard.
Yeah, and when the second half comes, you know, it's real easy to get discouraged and wonder if you're ever going to get things started. But just got to fight through it. Got to keep pounding away.
They're going to try for it on fourth. Winston stays out there.
Sonic! Ready! Blue lady! Sonic! Hey, sub! Let's go!
They'll try and throw for it here. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets this football out shy of the 30 to the 29.
Green, triple C.
Jameis now on first down. He finds an opening past the 40. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete. Here's second and 10 now from the 29.
Detroit! Detroit! Gone, gone! Gone, gone!
Ah! And now the first throw for the backup quarterback. He's got his tight end over the middle, O.J. Howard. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
When this offense can get their tight ends involved, they can move the football. Here, a nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the first down.
Gone, 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 gone! Gone, 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 gone! Gone, 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 gone!
They'll drop the throw. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed, because you hit a guy on the run like that, he often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively.
Set! Blue 90! Blue 90!
They'll look to throw here. Over the middle, he finds Godwin complete. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. 11 more yards there, and this methodical drive continues.
All right, now, lucky 56! Lucky 56!
Back to throw now on first down. Throw right side, caught by O.J. Howard. Another nice gain, 13 yards. Time at another first down. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. First down, he'll drop to throw. Airing this one out for Evans. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
Here's second and 10 now from about the 32.
Detroit! Detroit! Hurry up, here we go! Blue 90! Blue 90! Gone, gone! Gone, gone!
Ah! Back to throw now on second and 10. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. A good pickup there of 22. They'll set up a throw. That is caught at the 7-yard line. And here he'll get it down to the 7. Nice job defensively to hold him to 4, and now it's second and goal. He'll get it up the middle. And that didn't fool anybody. He's going to be dropped in the backfield. He lost 2 there, and it's third down.
What a game this defense has played. They're pitching a shutout,
So it'd be fun to watch down the stretch to see if their defensive coordinator continues to be as aggressive as he's been all game long.
This has been a long drive. You got to figure a field goal would be a letdown. Can they convert now on third and goal? Back to throw. And Evans hauls it in. Touchdown, Bucks. Mike Evans, his second touchdown on the season. And the Bucks are able to cut into that deficit. Elliott Good on the extra point. And it's now a 28-7 ball game. Elliott now to kick this one away. And now out come the Patriots. Now, the previous drive, they punted, but that was just the first time they've had to do so in this game.
And when they turn on the game film, the coaches will rant about this, right? They'll say, oh, God, we got to move the ball, guys. We can't punt the ball away. But they have to keep smiles off their faces because that's the first time in the game they've had to do so. They've moved it quite well. They'll overall be happy with what they've seen.
Detroit! Detroit!
They'll come out.
Really necessary. Get the message like a secretary. Boy, I'm legendary. When I'm dead and buried, still be kicking flavor in the cemetery. Trap music originator. Fresh off of my hiatus. Yelling you to all my haters. They skywalk, I'm Darth Vader. But promise I don't give a about them little mountain anywhere till a million out of them. Yup, like in the Kango Anna. New Cadillac with some all gold hammer. Long as I remember how to Atlanta. I can give a about a dog. Getting thing from a chat, so I count setting numbers in the hood. Do what I say, do tell me, break bread, a fake dead, a bit to hate that. 50 million, you die to make that middle. You vote for Trump, see me outside, well, you know what's up. I ain't hearing no peace talk, ain't funny, no hee haw. Like a Black Panther weak to the teeth, tribe weak. What I got, I could have been Freddie Gray. A Mike Brown getting down with a homie and a half a. Let me buy Sandra Bland. Listen, boy, you're challenging with the running man. I would challenge with a hand. What you see before you, what they told you from nothing, man. Grand hustle over everything. And hit the king like an 18 wheeler in and out of air lane. Never been a part of they in crowd. Got a problem with me, I said, yeah, I got the same friend that I came in with, ducking all that lane. Hey, everyone that knows on gold. I rolled in a 4x4. Believe if I kept gon' go, see me with ain't gon' see them no more. They love when I talk that roll by the car lot when bought it. Caught case at the case and a phone. They will watch you give a dip. Yeah. I live that they rapping back, catching them back with they capping back. They ain't roll mama, we know it did. We cashing out, we bagging that. Stacking up, there's zero. Certified neighborhood hero. You can try one of them. Better not try with me though. Hey.
Bring it in, bring it in. Boil it down by two. We're gonna go out here, run this play for the win. Let's go get it. I formation, 28 sweeps, blue 14. Watch left,
We to the mat, Atlanta hat, cop to the left, turn to the back. Try to see we weren't having that. Sit with your head, drop it out with Alabama at. That would get for trying to battle rap. Hit, be one and done. No drive, but we running. Walk up to you while you're showing a stunt till you up that jury and money. Playing game, thinking show no funny till my young win for me. Yeah. For the love of the bankroll, keep it bent. Don't nobody care about it, don't nobody wanna hear about it. You got problem, huh? Well, it's the same thing for everybody. I ain't gon' lie. I promise that a day go by. I ain't on the grind if I ain't on fire. If it one thing I want, then it can't go by. Tryna put seat wheels on a Range Rover. I ain't finna play no game, that what you know, so. If you think at the top, till I move over. Modern day Tupac in a new Hover. Know them, now come with us and down. We dodge a steady deck and clown. We chasing meals so we can butt that down. Top, but we run the town. But with millions in, with no cap and gown. We're all in what happened now. Metal throne, concrete crown. Call that line, you getting beat. Real, what veteran? What academy? Deep. They remember me when they're sick and needed their medicine. Better watch your partner, you even ride here. Thinking sweet, you got the wrong idea. Get left out there, tell them so what. I kept trap music, all black. Still, I'm that stupid. Still down to do it if you ask stupid. Get locked up and get back to it, yeah.
Trap music, I'm black. Get locked up and get back to it, yeah.
Baby, could you? I got too much on my mind right now. I ain't got the time to get you sent locked down. I got too much on my mind right now. Tell that hero, Dale, get my baby 30,000.